bum, 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 and not too soon, yap bum.
Yeah, this is too
young. Yap bum, 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 yeah, this, this.
Oh yeah.
I'm sorry, in my score, I'm sure it wasn't.
I believe you. I believe you. And again. Look, look where there is the whole 2/3 of the keyboard is unused. Only this extreme. And then you get.
I'm by nature a very curious person, and I'm full of curiosity to see what it is that such talented young people, from their perspective, with their curiosity, from today's world, how they come to this music and how we communicate about that. I find that for myself a very enriching experience. Beethoven, I think that the piano sonatas represent not only for the pianist, but for all musicians and music lovers, something unique in his output, and maybe unique in the output of many other composers. You know, it was Hans von Bülow who said that the well-tempered clavier of Bach was the Old Testament and the Beethoven sonatas were the New Testament. You know, I don't want to imbue this works with religious significance. But I think what he meant by that was that this is the basis of our knowledge of music.
At the same score, which is Beethoven wrote, right? But everybody has a different thinking, and obviously different, you know, doesn't mean good, or you're different, that doesn't mean you're different in a good way. And I think, but when you're talking about Master Barenboim, he can really bring the knowledge, the structure, how to put every element to one big shape.
The sonata form is, in a way, a statement of something positive, because you have two subjects usually, one very different from the other, one heroic and one lyric, one masculine and one feminine. And this is why a sonata form, if you want, in music, is such a lesson in life, that we have to know that we always need something to complement us, which is very often in different nature, in order to be able to fulfill ourselves. I think that this is very strong in Beethoven.
Thank you.
For me, the sonata is the illustration of how Beethoven can be humoristic. So it's typically the sonata where he shows his humor. And there's so many surprises. He plays with everything. He plays with the form, with the tonality. He plays with everything, basically.
Essence of Beethoven has very little to do with the zeitgeist, with the spirit of the time of today, where a work like controversy has become a dirty word, a negative word, where we want everything to be smooth, to be accepted by everybody, and now Beethoven music and the indications that he gives in the performance of this music is totally alien to this. It is about the necessity to push yourself to the limit. In the late piano sonatas, you see the writing pushed to both extremes of the keyboard. there is abruptness as well as gentleness. There is nobility as well as very plebeian music, if you want. I think each one of us has to find the images to describe that, or not. But I think that this is the essence of Beethoven, is that it does not shy away from the extremes, and it does not look for a synthesis that is made up through a reduction of the different elements.
I think what makes Beethoven so extraordinary in general, and the reason he captures the imagination of people and has for so many years, is because he shows you his struggles. You know, his compositional problems are apparent in the music. They have to be worked through, and generally one overcomes them at the end of it, when you come to the end of a piece of music. And in the variation movement, the last movement of 109, that's the overcoming of the problems is so profound and so moving that I can't almost think of any other piece of music, except for maybe the other two of those last three sonatas, that equals it.
Thank you.
really wonderful, Jonathan.
Stay with BBC4 for the story behind Beethoven's revolutionary Third Symphony, award-winning BBC drama Eroica, next.